again. It's Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Well, here we are another week in. We've survived so far, and we're kind of settling into a new normal of abnormality. So it's time to kind of stop, reflect, and in particular kind of review some of the settings and some of the things we've done in our networks. This talk today is inspired by a recent Twitter post from Jake Williams, founder of RenditionSec, and in his Malware Jake Twitter account, he reminded me that it's time to stop a bit, reflect, review, and kind of see what's going on in our environments and make sure that we've made the right choices. He recommended first and foremost that you use a scanning tool to review your external ranges for RDP ports open to the internet. If you find anything open out there, remember if you find it, the attackers can too. So make sure you configure it so that network level authentication is mandatory on anything. Now, preferably you'll have no RDP open to the external ports at all. Hopefully you'll tuck it behind RD gateway, or you'll put it behind a two-factor authentication such as duo.com. But you do want to do an external scan and make sure that you're safe. If you aren't familiar with external scanning, you can use tools like Nessus to do a port scan. There's other tools out there. You may look to your outside consultants to assist you. But bottom line, look to see what your outside ports look like to attackers. Because believe me, they're looking too. To set up the mandate for network level authentication, remember you need to go into group policy, go into computer policies, Windows components, remote desktop services, remote desktop session host, security, and then you want to go into the setting that is require user authentication for remote connections using NLA. You want to click on enabled, and you want to make sure you do this on the server that's running the RDSH role. Next, you want to take a look at your firewall logs and DNS logs to review what additional outbound traffic is suddenly going outside your network. You want to make sure that only those remote authorized tools that you think should be running are running. So if all of a sudden you see GoToMyPC or LogMeIn or TeamViewer or something that you didn't authorize going outbound, you want to make sure that it's not. So how can you look at your firewall logs? It all depends on which firewall vendor you have. Reach out to your firewall vendors. There are training courses out there for generic information on firewall log viewing. But in general, your best bet is reach out to your vendors, have them give you guidance and training on how to review those logs if you're not familiar with it. Next, you want to take a look at any additional configuration rules you've set up in the last week or so. Did you suddenly change them to make something work and maybe there's a better way to do it now? Perhaps you don't need it anymore. Again, reach out to your firewall vendors. If you made changes into any organizational units or Active Directory, again, take the time to go back and review. Do you still need to do it? Did you make file changes? Again, review the changes you've made in the last couple of weeks and make sure they're still effective. Especially because attackers are now trying to come in on our remote ports, it's time to review that maybe not everyone needs access to the same file sets that they used to. Maybe you can limit the access so that attackers can't get in as well. You've probably seen in the news this week all the issues and concerns about Zoom and security. But before you run to any conclusions, keep in mind that Zoom is making actually inroads into the security. They've stopped all feature updates and instead are focusing on security fixes. But if your firm is concerned about it, there are alternatives out there, including Microsoft Teams that can do the same ability. And now I'm going to talk about something that's a little bit awkward. You might be in the position right now to look to where you want to restrict or reduce the number of licenses. I hope that your firm hasn't been mandated to lay off or to shut down completely. But unfortunately, if you are in that situation, keep in mind that cloud services allow you to limit and reduce the number of licenses in an easy way. Even if you shut down a license, data is retained for a number of days. So look into that and look into your licensing to help you out in this situation. Keep in mind that Microsoft has opened up a free 6-month trial version of Microsoft 365 E1 to allow companies to better work from home. If you are a government customer, you should look into the Office 365 G1 trial. Educational customers should use the free Office 365 A1 license. These provide web-based versions of Office apps and business services. Last but not least, reach out to your vendors. Many of them are adding additional services or providing additional tools in this time. For example, Proofpoint is offering up free COVID-19 related IDS rules. And finally, don't forget the resources out at the IDG Tech Talk channel. This week we have How Will the Coronavirus Change How We Do Your Jobs? Until next time, stay safe, stay well, stay secure. This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.